What you see here is part from the Bible called History Channel. A very, very important part which I go to explain afterwards.
Rabbi Michael Bear Weissmandl, a childhood Talmudic and mathematical prodigy in Czechoslovakia prior to World War II, survived the Holocaust and after the war emigrated to the United States. Weissmandl, while still a young man, had stumbled onto the notes of the 13th century Rabbi Bakya, suggesting that divine information could be derived from the Torah by means of skipping a specific interval of letters. Now, with all the horror behind him, Weissmandl returned to the fascination of his youth, the possibility of a mysterious Bible code.
Rabbi Weissmandl, through his diligence and determination in his studies of the Torah, made some remarkable discoveries. The word Torah in Hebrew consists of four letters, a tau, a vav, a resh, and a he, which are equivalent for us to talk about it as if it was a T, an O, an R, and an H. We should note here that the Hebrew alphabet consists of 22 letters that are essentially consonants. Vowels are generally simply inferred. The vav operates sort of what we consider as an O, but it's not considered a vowel. In the book of Genesis, if you go to the first equivalent of a T and count 49 letters and then take the next one, in other words, the 50th letter, is the equivalent of what we would consider a vav. It's what we would consider an O. You count another 50 letters, it's a resh, or like our R. You count another 50 letters, and you come to a hey, or like an H. In other words, it's as if you found a T-O-R-H at 49-letter intervals. It spells the word Torah. Rather remarkable in its own right, but one of those things you could dismiss as just a happenstance. But when you get to Exodus, you discover the same thing happens. You come to a T, 49 letters plus 1, you get to the O, the R, and the H the same way. And so again, this starts to look very designed. In fact, it's rather interesting that this number 50 are the number of days from the Exodus to the giving of the Torah at Mount Sinai. In pursuing this further, you go to the book of Leviticus, the third book, and this nothing like this happens. But you go to the fourth book of the Torah, the book of Numbers, the same thing happens, but only if you spell Torah backwards. Kind of weird. You go to the book of Deuteronomy, again you find the equivalent thing, but only if you spell it backwards. Now, you wonder, what does this mean? And you stand back from it all. It's as if those four books are pointing to the middle book, two forward, two back, to the book of Leviticus. So you examine Leviticus more carefully and discover not 49 letter intervals, but 7-letter intervals. Every eighth letter, you have the word Yahweh, or the name of God. And you stand back from this whole thing and you realize the Torah is always pointing to the name of God. Rabbi Weissmandl's discovery is the first modern hint of hidden codes in the Bible, and of course has led to using computer to find others. Professor Daniel Michelson at UCLA has estimated that the probability of Weissmandl's discovery happening by accident is less than 1 in 3 million.
This discovery also has great significance to the ancient menorah lampstand, still used in Jewish practices today.
Like the lamps in Israel's ancient lampstand, the Hebrew word for law was encoded at 50-letter intervals in the opening paragraphs of Genesis and Exodus. The Eastern lamps point toward the servant lamp, the lamp of God, which was elevated above the others. Leviticus reveals that servant lamp design with Yahweh, the Hebrew word for Jehovah, encoded in 8-letter intervals in its opening verse. In the ancient menorah, the western lamps were reversed to point toward the servant lamp. Following that design, the word Torah was found to be encoded backwards in the introductory paragraphs of Numbers and Deuteronomy. Just as the lamps on either side of Israel's ancient menorah were ignited from the flame of the elevated lamp of God, these four encoded Torahs point to the glory of Yahweh, or Jehovah, in Leviticus.
It was Now what I'm going to do to explain this phenomena, why 50 in Genesis and Exodus and 8 in Leviticus, why in Numbers and Deuteronomy it goes backwards, and why in Deuteronomy only 49 skip. So definitely all of this needed explanation. And the explanation is with Kabbalah, because all the codes are basically from Kabbalah, from Moshe Kodevero, Abu Lafia. So to understand it, you need a little bit of knowledge in Kabbalah. And this is what I'm going to explain to you. So why 50, why five books? So we know, this is called to Kabbalah, the soul of man, the spirit, is divided into five parts. One which is above, which is called Yechidah, and there is another one, down Chaya, which is the Ora. Then you have in the brain, which is called Neshama. And then what you have, going backwards, it means you go down in the heart, you have the Ruach, and in the liver, or the dam, really basic, is the Nefesh. So these are the five books of Moses, which are parallel to the five books of the five parts of the soul, while Genesis is against the highest, Yechidah, Exodus against the second one, which is called Chaya, living, while the middle one is against the Neshama, the soul, and then you have Numbers, which again, which is called the Ruach, the spirit, and then the last one, Nefesh, the lowest part. So in English, it's difficult to understand all these five parts, because there are not such explanation to all of them. The explanation, we know spirit and soul, but Yechidah, the only one, the unique one, the living one, the Neshama, the soul, okay, and then the Ruach, which is the spirit, and the lowest part, which is the Nefesh. So, why 50-50 in this case goes from up to down, like we saw Torah, Torah, for up to down? Why in those one it goes down backwards, as you saw, backwards Torah, as before? And why 49? So the idea is the following. Moses got definitely the Torah from God, while Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, and Numbers were basically directly from God. And we know quite well that the complete and full understanding is 50 gates of understanding. So, those parts, the four parts directly from God, each one of 50-50. But we know that Deuteronomy, God definitely told Moses to write. Moses wrote it, but he wrote it himself according to what God told him. So therefore, it is 49, because our rabbis tell us that Moses got only 49 levels of understanding. When he passed away, just before, he was on the Mount of Nebo. Nebo means Nun Bo. Then he got the 50th. So amazingly, having exactly 50 and 49 here. Now, the question is why Genesis and Leviticus, Genesis and Exodus, really, Torah is from up to down, because the parts which are called Yechidah, the fifth highest part of the Neshama, is outside the body. The same thing, the second one, which is called Chaya. Now, what is the purpose of them? They bring down the energy down to man. To where? To the Neshama. Yeah, to Neshama. To the brain. Now the brain has four parts. Which are the four parts? Different brains, right, left, middle, and also the back. But amazingly, this is why the Jewish people put the tefillin on, and the tefillin have four compartments. Why? God's name is Yud-Kevav-Ke, yeah? These four letters of God also are against these four parts. Yud, the wisdom, the understanding. Yud is a Chokhmah. A, understanding. Then, knowledge, Vav, and Idot, and A, kingdom. But these also are against the four parts. Now, we know that in God's name, when you got Yud, Ke, Vav, Ke, on the Yud, on top, like a stroke, it is against the highest part. So the five really forms of the Hebrew name God are parallel to the five parts of the Neshama. So, what really a man is supposed to do, he gets the energy from above, the light from above, come to his brain, yeah, in which we have Neshama. Neshama is also like Shmone, eight, like the number of letter, the skip letter, eight. And then, what you have here, this is already the part of the spirit in the man, which is called the Ruach in the heart, and the Nefesh in the liver, the blood. So this is what a man have to work on. He have to elevate his Ruach, the emotions, the heart, up. And the same thing, the lowest part, the Nefesh, the material, have to put up. This is why the word Torah comes here from bottom to the up. So it means there's an amazing explanation, really, why the menorah, which is the five books of Moses, have this shape, why two from up to down, Torah, why here every eight letters, and then why numbers, and Deuteronomy is backwards, and why Deuteronomy only 49. So from here you learn the important lesson, that to understand fully Judaism, the Torah, and even the Bible code, we have to know Kabbalah, yeah? Which explains to you the build-up of the soul, how the five books of Moses are parallel to the souls, and exactly how it fits. There is explanation, definitely. So this is very, very important, as this is really the basis of the understanding of Bible code.